Now we will be starting on with the question answers. So please, children, mark the answers in the book. The first one, what was the position of the king in the Egyptian society? So come to page number 19. And the heading you will be writing, position of king in the Egyptian society. So we come to page number 19 under the heading society. First point you will be writing in this is from the second line, write your answer one. So children, the first point is the king had unlimited powers and was the political and religious head of his people. Now, second point starts from he. He was called the Pharaoh. Okay. Third point will start from he was considered to be God's representative on earth and his statues were installed in the temples. Okay. The fourth one, the last one is the people worshipped him as God. So, only we are having 4 points in the first answer. Now, we move to the second answer. Mention the contribution of ancient Egyptian in the field of astronomy. So, come to page number 23. Okay. Come to page number 23. Now, see under the heading, points to remember. Okay. Points to remember. So, you will be starting from the last one over here. The under the heading, contribution of the Egyptian, the last point. You will be writing the solar. Solar is not written in this. So, you have to add the word solar. The solar calendar. From here, you will start and end it 30 days each. Okay. Now, this is point one of the answer. Second point you will be writing from here under the heading astronomy. Second point you will be adding, 5 more days were added to the calendar for celebration of religious festival. So in overall we are having how many points? 2 points in this answer. So write your answer 2. This is the first point. From here to here we are having the second point. 5 more days and up till religious festival. So this was answer 2. Third answer. Why is the Egyptian civilization called the gift of the Nile? So come to page number 18. Now on page number 18, see under the heading location. Now under location you will be seeing here. It is written in the third line, it, but instead of it, you will be writing the Egyptian civilization. So you will write the Egyptian civilization flourished on the bank of river Nile, which flows along the entire length of Egypt. Without the river Nile, Egypt would have been a desert. There is hardly any rainfall in Egypt. Egypt is therefore called the gift of the Nile. So this is answer 3. Now let us move to answer 4. In this they are asking the important features of Egyptian art and architecture. So you will be writing the heading important features of Egyptian art and architecture. Come to page number 21. Now first heading you will be writing pyramids. Under the heading pyramids, you will be writing the first point. Okay, children, the most important, the most impressive movement of the Egyptians are the pyramids. They are large triangular structures. This is the first point under the heading pyramids. Second point will be the two most famous and spectacular ones are situated at Giza near Cairo. This is the second point. Third point you will be writing, pyramids were the tombs of pharaohs. Okay. So these many points we are having under pyramids. Under the same answer, the next heading will be the spinach. Okay. In this one, you will be writing the first heading, the first point. It is a fine example of Egyptian sculpture. Okay. Second point you will be writing from here. It is a mythological animal with the body of a lion and the head of a man. Then third point it is carved out of a single stone. It was meant to guard the pyramids. This is the second point. Third point, sorry. Okay. And then the fourth point in this will be the most remarkable among them is the Great Sphinx at Giza. And now the third one. Okay. These all were the points under the second heading. Now the third heading will be the temples at Karnak and Abu Simbel are very impressive and awe-inspiring. Okay. So we are having this much answer in answer 4. Now let us move to the next. What do you mean by hieroglyphic? Explain its features also. So children, come to page number 22. Page number 22. Now the first point you will be writing is, see under the Egyptian script. Now the third, this is answer 5th. Okay. This is answer 5th and this is the first point. The Egyptian developed a kind of picture writing known as hieroglyphic, which means sacred or holy writing. After this, in the same answer, you will write the heading features. Okay, the first point under features will be pictures and signs represented their ideas. Second is it had about 500 signs. Third, the Egyptians used pens made of reed. Fourth point, ink was made of gum and soot. And the last one, they wrote on the bark strips of a plant called papyrus. That's all. So these many points we are having. With this, we come to the end of the chapter. Okay. Now, one more exercise is left. Let us do that. Let us do picture study. Now here, children, you can see the picture of a pyramid. They are asking you to identify the picture. So which picture it is? It is the, you can see the same pyramid made on page number 21. It is the Great Pyramid. So add here the word G-R-E-A-T, Great Pyramid. Secondly, they are asking who built it and when. It was built by Pharaoh Cheops in 2650 BCE. Now they are asking what things did it contain? Come to page number 21. So you can write over here, instead of they, you can write, you have to write it. It contained mummies, cloths, jewelry, and many precious items. That's all. Okay. Only this much you will be writing. So with this we come to the end of this chapter. Thank you.